Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to yet another video here at the channel. In today's video, we're going to have a look at adding movements into your shots. And we're going to do this in post because very often you are shooting like a solo shooter, or maybe you are a small crew and you simply haven't enough people to make all these cool movements into your shots. So you end up by shooting on a tripod and making a steady shot. And in this video, I'll show you in three ways, or maybe four, on how you can make or add movements to your shot to make them look more dynamic and more interesting for your viewer. So without further ado, let's jump right into DaVinci Resolve and let's get started with this tutorial. Okay, so here we are in DaVinci Resolve, and I'm going to show you these movements you can do with a locked off shot as we have right here. It is just, again, me walking towards the AI hills, and we can make this look a little better by adding in movements. So, and we can do this in a lot of different ways, but one of the easiest way, of course, is just to go up to the inspector and going in here into transform, and then just hit the keyframe icon right here. And then let's say we'll go to the end of the clip. And at the end of the clip, we are going to want our scene to be at this position right here. Like that, maybe that is what we are going for. So let's see, we have this clip right here. Now we have some sort of a zoom in movement on the clip, which is kind of cool and makes it look a little more alive. However, we could also do this in a different way, and that is one of the ways I often do things. Go up to our effects, and we're going to our effects, and we're just adding in an adjustment clip. And an adjustment clip, this is the place where we are going to do our movement. And basically, we are going to do the same thing. We are just going to do it a little bit different. I'm going to zoom in, and I'm going to kind of position me in the center, and I'm going to see how much we can do, something like that. I'm going to put in a keyframe, and then I'm just going to go to the end of the clip, and I'm going to decide where I want my clip to, or my movement to end. And I want it to be like a reveal of the mountains here. So now we have a clip like this. Super cool, and it's super easy. It's like a pan, but it looks pretty good, I think. Another thing we could do would be just to go into the inspector again, selecting this clip here, and then we could use the dynamic zoom. And the dynamic zoom, just by selecting it, it's going to make a dynamic zoom, like so. I mean, it's pretty simple. We could also go into the option here and change it from linear to, let's say, ease in and out, and then just swap. And now it's just going to ease in. Again, super simple way of making this effect. Again, we could do it another way using the dynamic zoom tool. I'm just going to put it back on linear and swap. If we go into this icon here and change it down, we could also go into the dynamic zoom here. So for instance, we want the end should be the red one. So I want it to end in here. Maybe I want it to be like that. And then I'm just going to make the start, which is the green, like that. So it's going to do a little zoom in like so, which is kind of cool. Also, there is a plugin from Motion VFX. We can go into the Motion VFX in the effects here. I'm going to find it here. It is the M Camera Rig, and this is a free plugin. I'm just going to put it on, and now it has a in zoom and stuff like that. Of course, like it is with Motion VFX, it has a lot of different options in the camera controls. We can change the zoom and the position and stuff like that. So if we just change stuff around, and you can use the keyframes to keyframe it the way you want it. We also have some effects control. We can take off the sharpening, and you can add in prism blur and stuff like that. Gaussian blur, you can take that off as well. There's a lot of things to play around with. And again, this is a free plugin for Motion VFX. There will be a link for Motion VFX down in the description below. Also, if you want to check out some of the other packs they have there, you can use that link. I'm going to get a little bit of kickback if you use the link. It's not going to cost you anything else. Just make me make more content. That's all. A pretty cool little thing where we can make movements like that. And of course, if you don't want to download a plugin, of course, you can just go up to the Open Effects, right, the camera, and use the camera shake, and that's going to give this effect a handheld look, which is also another way of adding in movement. Of course, if you just put it in default, it's going to look terrible. However, if we go into the inspector and we go up to the open effects, we can take the motion scale and bump that down quite a bit. The speed scale will do the exact same thing, and also the pan and tilt will drag that down just a little bit. Now we have something which is a little bit of movement, and of course you could bump this up if it's not enough for you. So we have this little movement giving it the effect that it's a handheld shot, which is also a cool technique. I've used this technique a lot of times before, and it's always giving a little bit of life into your image. Anyway, I do hope you found this little video useful. If you did, please hit that subscriber button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it would help them out, and if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on this channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.